أبنائي الأعزاء، طلبة وطالبات الصف الأول الثانوي لغات، تحية طيبة وبعد. عدت إليكم اليوم مرة ثانية وفي لقاء جديد. إن شاء الله اليوم سوف نتحدث عن applications, some applications on using vectors, some applications on vectors. Its title is, as we said, applications on vectors. The first application is the force. What does the force mean? أكيد معظمنا يسمع عن كلمة force، ولكن تعالوا نشوف المعنى العلمي لفورس عندنا في الماث ماذا يعني. The force is a vector. يبقى الفورس في الأصل هي vector. Is a vector passed through a given point and acting along a straight line and also and it representing by a directed line segment. So the force means vector. Vector passing through a given point and acts along a straight line and it is representing by a directed line segment. We have another definition, the resulting force. Another thing is resulting force. If we have many forces, if F1 and F2 and so on, any forces acts at a particle, then their resultant is F, where F, notes F is a vector, F1, F2 are vectors. So F here means the resulting force equals F1 plus F2 plus and so on. If the resulting force here means an equivalent force, do the same doing of the different forces F1 and F2 and so on. Units of measuring forces are Newton, kilogram, weight, gram, weight. And we have another forces as dyon and so on. Now I have an example. The first example tell us the forces F1 equal equal 5i plus 2g, F2 equals -2i plus 7g, F3 equals 3i minus g. Find their resultant in magnitude and direction. The required here find the resultant and in magnitude and E and direction. Notes F1, F2 and F3 are written in the form fundamental unit forms using I and G. I and G, remember that the unit vectors in directions of X and Y axes. First of all, to find the value of the resultant, remember that F must be equal F1 plus F2 and F3. So the first point in our solution, remember that F here again equal F1 plus F2 plus F3. So to find F in a direct in a vector form, you must add F1, F2 and F3 like this. F equal 5i plus 2g plus -2i plus 7g plus 3i minus g. They are the three forces. So we can add them, add x coordinates firstly and after that y coordinates in the second time. So we can add 5i plus -2i plus 3i, their sum is 6i, and add also 2g plus 7g minus g, their sum is 8g. So if in a vector form equals 6i plus 8g, How can we find the magnitude of R here? The magnitude here means the norm, of F. Who can tell me how can we find the magnitude of any vector? Any vector in the form of x and y, so its norm is square root of x square plus y square. So the magnitude of the resultant is norm of f equal square root of 6 square plus 8 square. So f equal 10 unit force. If the unit of f1, f2, f3 is any one of the units in the previous, we can use it as Newton, kilogram weight, gram weight, and so on. Here the unit is not given, so the unit of the force is 10 unit force. How can we find the direction? The direction here means the theta, and in the previous we can find theta by using the rule tan theta equals y over x. So here tan theta equal 8 over 6 by using the calculator, measure angle theta equal 53 degrees and 8 minutes approximately. Theta here means the angle which the position of if is the resultant and with the positive direction of x-axis. Again, theta here means the angle between the direction of f and the positive direction of x-axis. Now we have two very important remarks. The first, F2 forces are equal in magnitude and opposite in directions and act on the same straight line. Ask yourself, if a body, two forces act on it, the two forces equal in magnitude, opposite in direction. In this case, their resultant must be equal zero, so F equal zero. So the first remark, if two forces are equal in magnitude and opposite in directions and act on the same straight line, then their resultant must be equal zero vector, or F vector equal zero vector. We have another remark, if a system of forces meeting at a point and they are in equilibrium. So what can we deduce? Again, this remark, again, if a system of forces, if we have many forces meeting at a point here means a body or a particle, and they are in equilibrium, so we can deduce that their resultant equal zero vector, or F equals zero, and vice versa. Axe number two is a true. If many forces, their resultant equal zero, so must be they in equilibrium. Equilibrium يعني معناه أي حد يرى. في equilibrium يعني اتزان, يعني جسم ساكن لا يتحرك. Now I have example. If F1 equal 5i minus 3j, F2 equal ai minus 2j, F3 equal negative 7 and b, find the value of a and b if they are in equilibrium. Remember that these forces are in equilibrium, so their resultant must be equal zero. And this is the main rule to solve this problem. Remember that F1 equal 5i minus 3j minus 3j, I can write it as an ordered pair, F1, 5, and negative 3. Also, F2 equal ai minus 2j, I can write it as a and negative 2. The third force, F3 equal negative 7 and b. Since the system is in equilibrium, therefore F equal 0. F1 plus F2 plus F3 equals 0 vector. So 5 and negative 3 plus A and negative 2 plus negative 7 and B equals 0. We can add 5 plus A plus negative 7 and add negative 3 plus negative 2 plus B. So we can find this form, the order where A and negative 2, A minus 2, comma B minus 5 equals 0. A minus 2, which is equal 5 minus 5, sorry, plus A plus negative 7 equals A minus 2. B minus 5, which is equal negative 3 plus negative 2 plus B equals 0. So A minus 2 here must be equal 0, and B minus 5 also equal 0. A minus 2 equals 0, so A equals 2. B minus 5 equals 0, so B equals 5. Another example, if F1 equal 5i minus 3j, F2 equal ai minus 2j, F3 equal negative 7 and b, find the value of a and b if their resultant equal 5i minus 3j. Note this example is the same previous example, but in the previous example the forces are in equilibrium. Here the resultant equal 5i minus 3g. So we can solve this problem easily like this. We can write first of all F1 equal 5 and negative 3, F2 equal a and negative 2, F3 equals negative 7 and b, F is the resultant equal 5 and negative 3. So F1 plus F2 plus F3 equal F, therefore 5 comma negative 3 plus A comma negative 2 plus negative 7 and B equals 5 and negative 3. So A minus 2, B minus 5 equal 5 and negative 3. Where we get this form, we add in the previous step 5 plus a plus negative 7 equals a minus 2, and also add negative 3 plus negative 2 plus b equals b minus 5. So a minus 2 and b minus 5 order the pair equal 5, and negative 3 also order the pair. So a minus 2 equals 5, a minus 2 equals 5, b minus 5 equals negative 3. So a equals 5 plus 2, therefore a equals 7, and b minus 5 equals negative 3, so b equals negative 3 plus 5, therefore b equals 2. Now I have another application. Its name is relative velocity. Relative velocity, it's a definition: if we have two bodies A and B, and the velocity of the velocity vector of A is VA, and the velocity vector of B is VB. So the relative velocity of A with respect to B is VAB. Which is equal VAB equal VA minus VB. So the relative velocity of A with respect to B, its symbol is VAB, and VAB equals VA minus VB. Also the velocity or the relative velocity of B with respect to A is VBA. So VBA equal VB minus VA. Now I have example application on relative velocity. Example 4, a car A moves on a straight road with velocity 72 km per hour, and a car B moves on the same road with velocity 28 km per hour. Find the velocity of the car A relative to the car B. If Find the relative velocity of car A relative to car B means relative velocity of A with respect to B means VAB. We have two cases. The first case, the two cars moves in the same direction, and the second required is the two cars moves in opposite directions. So the problem here we want to find the relative velocity of A with respect to car B in these two cases. If the two cars have the same direction, the two cars moves in opposite direction. First of all, you must learn if the two cars in the same direction, their sign is positive. Their sign is must be positive, because the velocity, as we said, is a direct line segment, is a vector. So the direct line segment or the vector have a direction. First of all, again, if the two cars in the same direction, so the two cars, their velocities are positive. So VA equals 72 kilometer per hour, and VB equal also V 28 kilometer per hour. Note the two units are the same. If the two units of the two velocities are different, you must change one of them to be the same of the other. VAB, this is the velocity of A with respect to B equal VA minus VB, which equals 72 minus 28 equal 44 kilometer per hour. This is the velocity of the car A with respect to car B. In the second required, remember the two cars moves in opposite direction, so one of them must be negative. It's easy to make the second is negative. So VA equals 72 kilometer per hour and VB equals negative 28 kilometer per hour. Remember, why did VB is negative? Because it in opposite a direction of VA. So we can find the VAB, which is velocity, relative velocity of A with respect to B, as the same by using the same rule. VAB equal VA minus VB equals 72 minus negative 28 equals 72 plus 28 equals 110 kilometer per hour. Now, أبنائي الأعزاء, وصلت معكم إلى نهاية لقاؤنا اليوم. أتمنى أن تحوز إعجابكم جميعا. اللهم إن كان هذا اللهم إن كان هناك توفيق فهذا منك وحدك لا شريك لك, وإن كان هناك تقصير أو سهو أو نسيان فهذا مني ومن الشيطان. أستودعكم الله الذي لا تضيع ودائعه, وألقاكم في لقاء آخر, والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.